I learned something today that rocked my world as a hobbyist. Refractometers don't measure salinity, hydrometers don't measure specific gravity, and salinity probes, well... Salinity measures the concentration of salt in the ocean. It is the measurement of the weight of dry salt compared to the weight of the water. The only way to actually measure this is to take a specific amount of seawater measured by weight, evaporate all the water away until you're only left with dry salt, and then weigh the dry salt. This is obviously not very practical for hobbyists. We express salinity in parts per thousand, so 35 parts per thousand actually means that 3.5% of the weight of seawater is due to the salt content. Specific gravity, also known as relative density, is the ratio of the density of seawater compared to the density of fresh RODI water. Since it is purely a ratio of two things, there is no unit of measurement for specific gravity. So while specific gravity cannot directly tell us the concentration of salt in the water, by telling us how dense the seawater is when compared to RODI water, we can infer how much salt is dissolved in the water and thus approximate salinity. Okay, since none of us are actually going to boil down a fresh batch of seawater every week in order to weigh the remaining dry salt, we're not directly measuring salinity. And since I don't even know how to begin to measure the ratio of the density of seawater compared to the density of RODI water, then we're clearly not directly measuring specific gravity. So what in the name of Poseidon's trident are we actually measuring? Well, there are three different tools that we use in this hobby, and each one of them measures something a little different. Hydrometers measure buoyancy. These use some sort of floating mechanism that is calibrated to a certain temperature. The denser the liquid being measured, the higher it will float. But since the density of water changes with temperature, it's important that your tank water temperature matches the calibration temp in the hydrometer. So with a hydrometer, we are actually measuring how dense the water is, meaning how many things are dissolved in it. And we are assuming that the vast majority of those dissolved things are actually salts, and thus we're able to infer how much salt is in that water. A refractometer uses the refraction of light in water to approximate salinity. Changes in the concentration of salt affect the refraction of light. A refractometer is able to measure how much diffraction is occurring and display the results in a graduated scale. So a refractometer merely measures light refraction. Which, when measuring seawater, we assume that the more refraction there is, the more salt is in the water, thus again allowing us to approximate the salinity of the water. And lastly, we have salinity probes, which measures the conductivity of the water, meaning the degree to which it conducts electricity. A salinity probe measures the conductivity by passing an electric current between two electrodes. The more salt that is dissolved in the water, the greater its capacity to conduct electricity. The greater the conductivity, the more salt. So once again, a salinity probe does not actually measure the amount of salt in the water. Honestly, I can't say for certain which tool is going to be the most accurate. The only way to be sure of its accuracy is to use some sort of calibration fluid like this refracto juice from BRS. Hobby grade hydrometers can't be calibrated and they require you to use a specific temperature of water for accurate results. Refractometers also require a certain temperature, but they can be calibrated using something like the BRS refracto juice. Salinity probes also require calibration, but they are easy to use and adjust automatically for temperature differences. If I was a betting man, I would place my money on either the salinity probe or the refractometer to give you the most accurate results. I think every hobbyist needs a refractometer. They're super sturdy and they hold their calibration really well. Our refractometer here at BRS comes with calibration fluid, and it takes you less than a minute to calibrate, and it may hold its calibration for the rest of its usable life. Although a little bit more expensive, I use the Hanna salinity tester for my everyday needs. It's 100% waterproof, but it does need to be recalibrated every month. It is definitely easy to use and way more convenient than a refractometer. But if you want to go super fancy, then the Milwaukee Digital Seawater Refractometer might be the one for you. It's just like the refractometer we already mentioned, except this one reads the results for you. The first thing you need to do with your BRS refractometer is to calibrate it. Lift the daylight plate and place 2 to 3 drops of the calibration solution into the prism. Close the daylight diffusion plate so that the water spreads across the entire surface of the prism. Sometimes I find a gentle tapping can help this along. Wait for 45 seconds for the sample to get to room temperature. Hold the refractometer toward a natural light source and look into the eyepiece. Focus the eyepiece so you can read the results clearly. If the calibration fluid reads 35 parts per thousand, you're finished. But if not, remove the cap from the adjustment screw. Use the included screwdriver to adjust the refractometer until it reads 35 parts per thousand or 1.026 specific gravity. Replace the cap and you're done. Always clean your refractometer and pipette with RODI water and allow to dry completely before storing it. To calibrate the Hanna salinity tester, remove the battery cover and pop out the battery and remove the safety strip on the battery before putting it back into place. Rinse your new probe in RODI water and dry it. Cut open the top of the Hanna calibration solution. With the salinity tester on, press the CAL button. Once the 35 part per thousand use is displayed, insert probe into the calibration solution. Tap the tester a couple times to remove any air bubbles. Leave in place until after the REC is no longer displayed and the tester returns to measurement mode. Hanna does recommend a monthly calibration for your salinity probe. To use the salinity tester, merely insert the entire probe into the sample water. Leave it in place until the hourglass stops blinking and you're done. Then just rinse it in RDI water and give it a couple shakes to dry it before storing it. Moving on to the Milwaukee Digital Seawater Refractometer. I already made a video about how to calibrate and use it, so we'll put a link in the description below. I have made some accidental yet deadly mistakes when it comes to salinity in my tanks. For example, I have accidentally filled up my ATO reservoir with seawater instead of RODI water and didn't catch my mistake until the tank almost crashed. There is but one piece of equipment I could have purchased that would have prevented that entire mess. Check it out by watching this video right here. And as always, thanks for watching. Happy reefing. Be well. We'll see you next time.